So, once again, you are stuck on that terrible traffic jam on the way back home. And you think, soon they'll fix the freeways and it won't be jammed anymore. This video will tell you why you're horribly wrong and why the freeways will never get better, only worse. Now first, you need to recognize this, that your freeways combined form a system of freeways. And a system, as defined by the dictionary, is a combination of parts that work together to perform a singular function. Now, for a system to work, it needs at least most of its components. If that requirement is not met, the system cannot work. And that is the case with our freeway systems. As an example, I will use the Los Angeles West Side, the most congested region in this entire country, as my example. As you can see, there are only two major freeways in this entire area. That's the 405 and the 10. And it's no secret that these two freeways are among the most jammed in the United States. Now the reason to why they're congested is very complex, but to put into layman's terms, too much cars, not enough road. So, you say, it must be the government's fault. They did not plan for the long term when they designed the system, and that's why it's so jammed today. Well, you're wrong. The government has planned the freeway system incredibly well. Out of the 6 freeways it planned for the West Side, 2 was built, 1 was half built, and 3 were completely unbuilt. And that is why we have such congestion in the West Side. I want you to imagine your commute if we had the Laurel Canyon, Santa Monica, Slauson, and Gardena freeways. Big improvement, right? With other cities, it's the same story. The Embarcadero, Golden Gate, and Central freeways in San Fran, the Inner Loops in Washington, D.C., the Inner Belt in Boston, and most famously, the 2 Cross Manhattan expressways in New York City along Canal and 42nd Streets. I'm not saying that these freeways are good. In fact, from an urban planning perspective, they suck. But these freeways were proposed to be the centerpieces of their city's infrastructure, and the fact that they're not built means the rest of the system cannot function efficiently, and that's why you have traffic jams. So why can't we just build them now, you ask? Well, let's show some examples, shall we? In Los Angeles, the Laurel Canyon and Santa Monica freeways would have both sliced right through Beverly Hills. Good luck with that. And in New York, need I say more? So, in a nutshell, unless these gets built, then our freeway systems can't function. And since they're not likely to be built ever, our freeway systems are not likely to function ever. So, our current experimentation with carpool lanes, toll roads, etc, 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 are just a waste of time because no matter what, we can't compensate for the fact that our centerpieces are missing from this system. And without those, no improvement could possibly bring this system back to a functioning state. It's like trying to put a turnip into the empty cranium of a brainless man and expecting him to function. Now we're starting fresh by building public transport in our cities. So let's pray that this story will have a much better ending than, oh, it sucks because we never finished it. Thanks for watching.